expenditures and revenue.
I broke those down a little bit differently, and these are going to reflect going to look a little bit more like our one-page budget item when we get ready to send it out. Right now, our budget, total budget, is going to be up $187,760. We have a revenue budget that is potentially going to be up $219,020. That is due, as you can tell from the following. We are using reserves, both in terms of Evalar and the other pieces that we've talked about. We are carrying forward approximately $270,000, at least we're anticipating, which is going to leave, you know, our potential, I'm going to use that capital P, potential tax levy, is $3,226,191. I have, since I printed this, made other adjustments. And again, so I'm saying this is very tentative, only because, you know, figures are coming in from state every day, expenses are getting a little bit clearer as we go on, so I'm making adjustments. But right now, that's what we're looking at least ballpark, okay? And you can see that represents right around a 2% tax levy. If you pull out the next sheet, which is the property tax levy limit calculations, you can see that our tax levy limit is actually $3,255,187. So with our proposed or potential right now 2% tax levy, it is below what our levy limit is, at 2.9. Okay? If you add in our coming year exemptions, and I told you the challenge of trying to figure out what those are, the conservative number that I used was 55,616. Our maximum allowable tax levy, the limit is going to be approximately 4.66%. Okay? Now, the way this works is that if our coming budget that we propose to the taxpayers is at $3,255,188 or below, we need a simple majority to pass the budget, which is 50% plus one. Anything above that dollar figure, you've got to have a supermajority or 60% of the voters vote in favor of the budget. And it cannot go above the 4.66%, no matter what, even though it's 60%. Nope, that's as far as it can go.